Amazing. So very good evening, everyone. As told by Sharmila, my name is Ayushi. By profession, I'm the CEO and co-founder for Shunyapai. And at the moment, I'm helping startups and SMEs to, you know, brand themselves to come up in the market with a completely new user base. Today, I'm very grateful to Blend Talks for inviting me here on their platform and giving me the opportunity to share my experiences with everyone here. And not taking much of your time, I'll just go ahead with the main purpose we all are here for. Exactly, entrepreneurship. Something for which we all are curious about. A name which we heard it so normally these days, every 12th passed out student wants to be an entrepreneur. Every person, let's say if he's into a job or if he's into his college or something, everyone wants to be an entrepreneur. But the main purpose is we haven't even understood that what an entrepreneur means. Simply, an entrepreneur is a person who just analyzes the problems in the society, who just analyzes what needs to be corrected, and he finds a solution for it, and he present mutually beneficial solutions for it. That's what Musk did. He felt the need of electric cars in the society. He made one. Let's call about CRED, Kunal Shah. He felt the needs of, you know, financial management things. He made one. So an entrepreneur is all about bringing a change in the society. And at the moment, a lot of students, a lot of people, a lot of professionals, they all are getting attracted to it just because of one single reason. And I think most of the people who are there in this webinar will definitely agree by it. We are here at that stage, and especially after this pandemic, we are at the stage where everyone wants to be self-employed. They don't want to be dependent upon someone, or they don't want to risk their family on behalf of a salary or something, or they don't want to depend upon an organization to run their family. So everyone is thinking about the self-employment, or everyone is concerned about this entrepreneurship word, and thereby how it gained its momentum. Going ahead, how it all started. So entrepreneurship, I think it's all about the idea at the very first stage. The way I say that, it's all about analyzing the market trends. It's all about, identifying what is there in the market, what problem is there, and how we can bring a solution to it. So idea is really crucial, and it's just not the idea that matters. It's probably an idea should come into the existence, and for coming into the existence, you need to execute it well. And that execution probably comes from planning, strategies, everything. So you need to constantly work upon your idea. You need to strategize things, and you need to present it to the people. Shunyapai. I'll tell you about Shunyapai, the way how we guys started. If I tell you about myself, before establishing Shunyapai, I failed into two startups. It was going well, but due to some market situations or some of, because I was not experienced much. So yes, I did fail, and I failed twice. But then this third startup, Shunyapai, came into existence, and accordingly, we started going on to the track. Idea was the main thing that made Shunyapai onto the track. And yes, I want to say one thing here, that a lot of entrepreneurs think that funds is a major issue to start a business. To starting a business, they might need funds, they might need to go for a debt, or they might need to put their jewelry with the bank or their house papers with the bank, but I'm sorry, that doesn't really happen. Shunyapai was started with zero funds, with zero investment, not even a single penny. We are three people, and we started normally. We just brainstormed our ideas. We take it into consideration, and there's how it formed. And at the moment, Shunyapai is an organization which is incubating startups, not just incubating itself, but many more startups. Yes, you might see Dream Gadgets and ADD. They are the two startups which have been incubated by Shunyapai. ADD is a purely educational firm. And yes, Dream Gadgets is basically an
IoT production, it deals in IoT production and designing and everything. So they both are incubated and collaborated by Shrinipa, and that's how we are working into major domains. Going ahead with it, I think if I talk about myself, I used to, you know, search for a lot of opportunities for a longer time. I used to be very active on LinkedIn. I used to be very active on a lot of platforms, on Reddit and everything. Always in the craze of finding an opportunity. But later, at later stages, I discovered that more than finding an opportunity, why don't we guys feel the need of creating an opportunity? Rather than going out and finding how we can collaborate, I mean, how we can...
37882.
37882. Yes, sorry, Aishi, continue, please.
No problem. A very famous person has recently made a statement that this is an era. We are living into a stage where people have an immense power to, you know, we have an immense resources, immense power to, you know, be a millionaire. And why do people say this? Because it's simply, we are at a stage whereby we have gone through a lot of things. There was a time when we were under British rule. There was a time when India was evolving. We got our independence. We were fighting wars in the 1970s with Indochina and everything. Then liberalization occurred. When India was going through liberalization, there were Western countries being developed. When we were sitting in our school, there was Steve Jobs building Apple. And at the moment, we are at the stage whereby we and the developing nations, we are at the same stage. 2015, it's the age of the communication. Everything is dependent upon communication. The way you speak is the way you influence people, is the way you build yourself, your personal branding, your business branding. Everything depends upon the way you communicate. So this is an era to make a change. I have seen a lot of people, they used to say that we don't have opportunities. You have an immense possibilities around you. You just need to, you know, change your focus, change your perception. You move out, you see there's possibility in every small thing. You just need to move out. You just need to figure out things well. And if still you are not getting something, I always say, people, go and create one for yourself. It hardly matters. Shrinipa was created in the same manner. We've got nothing. We were all at the very initial beginnings of our career. But we created one for ourselves. And this is how we are leading the market now. Going ahead with the entrepreneurship. What is entrepreneurship all about? And what do we need? Just go ahead with it. Or to just incubate that spirit in us. It's very simple. Huh? It's energy. It's integrity. And it's intelligence. Firstly, going with integrity, one of my favorite aspects. Integrity is all about honesty. Being honest to what you really are feeling, being honest to yourself, being honest to your work, and being honest to, you know, your surroundings is really, really essential. I think a lot of people don't have the guts to do that, to be even honest to themselves. Many a times I have felt it that I don't know if you people have even traveled through Delhi Metro. You might have discovered while, you know, in the morning while people are going through the office, they seem tired or they seem exhausted. And when they are returning from it, it seems like, and especially on the Friday weekend, you know, Friday evenings, they're like completely free. It means that they are not enjoying their work. The work or the job they are putting the 40 years of life to, they're not enjoying that. So this is something you're not honest to yourself, but you need to do it. The 9-to-5, you know, that basic trap. And everyone needs to get out of it, but they're not even able to convince themselves. So firstly, you need to have the courage to do that, to at least be honest to yourself. Yes, a lot of people might have this question at the moment that 9-to-5 is supporting our livelihood. I understand. But there are people who are utilizing their 8 hours in the job and their next 8 hours in building something for themselves. So it's all about the perception. Nothing else matters. Energy. I believe energy is one of the very crucial things that matters. I think you might have heard a thought. आपके आसपास जो पांच लोग होते हैं वो आपका ब्रेन अफेक्ट करते हैं. इट्स वेरी ट्रू. यू आर द एवरेज ऑफ फाइव पीपल अराउंड यू. सो यू आर द एवरेज. योर एनर्जी इज द एवरेज ऑफ फाइव पीपल्स एनर्जी अराउंड यू. व्हाट एनर्जी यू आर कंज्यूमिंग अराउंड यू इज व्हाट विल रिफ्लेक्ट आउट. सो मेक श्योर यू आर विद पीपल हु आर रियली पॉजिटिव, हु आर रियली पैशनेट, हु आर रियली एम्बिशियस, एंड यस, हु आर ऑनेस्ट एंड काइंड टू देमसेल्व्स. थर्डली गोज अबाउट द इंटेग्रिटी. I'm sorry, intelligence. So if talking about the entrepreneurship things, it's really important to be a problem solver. Entrepreneurs are basically the change makers. They are change makers, they are problem solvers, they are policy makers. So you really need to incubate these things into yourself. You know, you should have a decision-making power. You should have the crisis management thing in yourself. And if you don't have one, it hardly matters. You learn it through your journey. You'll incubate it in yourself. Going ahead with it. In our entrepreneurship journey, there's a lot of things, right? While starting it, personally, I had a lot of myths about it. Money's entrepreneurship. It's a very first myth. People think about it that entrepreneurship is all about, you know, having a huge money, then putting it into a business and then multiplying it, you know, creating huge, huge wealth, which is actually not true. Entrepreneurships, just observe the entrepreneurs around you, whether it's Ritesh Agarwal, whether it's Kunal Shah, or whether it's any entrepreneur. They started with zero. They started with minimal investment. And that is, you know, this entrepreneurship is one opportunity which is being given to us with people like us who don't have much funds, but we want to do something big in our lives. I think what separates the middle class from rich is like rich gets richer and poor gets poorer. It's simply because rich, we all say that rich has that resources. Entrepreneurship is one way whereby we middle class people or we normal people, we are getting up our resources or we are pooling our resources and we are creating something big. Funding and investors. It's a myth. It's easy to get. I also used to think before getting into the business that it's really simple. Just get out an idea of a startup and it's been, you know, it's really simple to just go ask an investor that like, let's fund in the business. No, it's not. Getting fundings and investments is a huge deal. You need to be visionary for that. You need to have an idea that can be, you know, a bigger change in the society. You might have seen the recent example for CRED. CRED has been recently valued at $2.2 billion. And it has been recently funded by Sequoia Capital, Tiger Capital, and a lot of investors, right? Basically, CRED just had a vision, right? If you talk about the CRED's last year profit, it was just 52 lakhs. Many companies clocked their, you know, monthly revenue of 52 lakhs. And CRED has this, you know, yearly revenue. They lose, you know, when they are spending 1 rupee, they are losing 712 rupees on every single rupee. So why would investors invest into it? They simply had a strategy that CRED is an organization which can, you know, lead to a vision. You know, India is a country whereby people are very good at algebra or trigonometry, but they are very bad at money management. And that's really, really true. And CRED is an organization which is making people financially literate and they are helping people to manage their finance. So it had a vision. Investors supported it. A lot of skills required. I think skill is something which is continuously upgraded with time. You don't need to learn a lot of skills and then come into the business. It will take a lot of your time. This is a time to in your 19s, your 20s, your 21st, 22 is the time whereby you need to gain maximum experience, either by doing it yourself or by watching your surroundings. So don't just wait to gain all the skills. You will never be able to. There will always be some other upgradation in your surroundings. And if you think that you learn everything and then you'll enter into the market, you'll never be able to. So please remove all these myths. We'll come on to the facts part. Yes, no one will join your vision. That's what I said. CRED had a vision, and that's why investors supported it. So you need to have a vision with a very strong idea and a strong planning and strategy, and you will be able to attract as many investors as you want. Yes, skills, not actually a problem. Have gone for an interview or something. You don't know something, that's perfectly amazing. They won't question you much, but you should have the power to learn. And you should have a learning attitude and a positive attitude is what really matters. And the same thing happens in this journey as well. In your entrepreneurship journey as well as in your life, you need to have a very positive attitude towards it. And thirdly, solving problems. Yes. As I told, entrepreneurship is all about solving problems to create mutually beneficial solutions. That's what Zomato did. That's what Uber did. That's what Swiggy did. That's what Amazon did. That's what Oyo did. And that's what Ola did. I mean, all these startups, they started from nothing and had been everything. So it's all about solving problems. That's what I say, that when it comes to solving problems, that's what an entrepreneur do. He should have a problem-solving attitude. A lot of people, I usually observe that there are a lot of people at the time when there are crises on their head, they lose their, presence over it. And it should not be done. An entrepreneur is someone who has a control over their mind. They take the control of the entire situation and they manage things pretty well. So you should have problem-solving attitude and you should know how to manage the crisis, at least personally, not organizationally, but at least for yourself, that you should not be, you will be able to calm at least yourself. Open-minded, it's really essential to be open-minded. If, you need to come up into the market, you need to be open to the changes the market offers every single time. After every, a few months, the market has a new trend, the market has a new change, and you need to adapt yourself accordingly. If you won't, you'll be like Nokia or ambassador. What happened with Nokia? Nokia came into the market. Once it was the topmost mobile brand with 95% of market captured. But at the moment, it's not even 9.5% of market captured. And the basic reason for that is simple. Nokia then changed itself according to the trend. When there was a time for the Android, Nokia didn't accept it. And today it's nowhere. Ambassador, what happened to it? Same case. They never understood what the market is asking for. They didn't change themselves according to it, and they are nowhere in the market now. Market wants change makers as well. And third, risk appetite. An entrepreneur must have the power to take a risk. I always say calculated risk. You should always have the power to take calculated risk, not just for yourself, but for the organization. So a risk appetite is actually a very must to be an entrepreneur. And yeah, going ahead with it, what to do? You have gotten to the journey, and now what's next? Simply, you need to learning, then you are not evolving. Even if you talk about a human, a baby evolves, a human evolves from a baby to an adult, and they go through a lot of changes in the process. So humans continuously evolve. So it's just, we are just people. We need to continuously evolve things around us. We need to evolve internally. We need to learn a lot of skills. We need to face a lot of challenges and learn experiences out of it. Go find to find home. Have you ever understood about the mechanical energy? Or let's give it an example. Have you seen volcano? The deeper it is, the more powerful it is. So the deeper you will go into the things, the deeper, you will be a master in what you're actually doing, the finer you will become. Take a niche of yours. Excel into it, master into it, take a good command over it, and you'll just be perfect for your field. There's nothing else required. MS Dhoni, he started his career with from I think the being a TC in the railway ministry, in the in the railway job or something. He knew it, that it isn't his niche. He discovered that he is someone who is made for the sports, who is made for cricket. That's what Sachin Tendulkar is also all about. He might not be good in academics, might not be good in some other sports, but he's good in his sport. He made a mastery into it, and today he's the finest player, one of the finest players. Same as with Virat Kohli. Their dedication towards their sports and their, you know, perseverance, their continuous, you know, dedication towards it has made Virat Kohli what he is today. So go every time, just refine yourself for more, just be finest. Change your attitude. I always say, in the previous slides I said too, that your attitude really reflects things about you. So it's very essential for you to have a positive attitude. Just be positive about yourself, about your surroundings, about about all the things around you, because it'll definitely affect your mindset here. So you need to be very focused about it, and you need to be very sorted about what you are consuming. As I just said that you are the average of the five people around you. So make sure your surroundings should be very much positive. Your surroundings should be very much aspiring. Your surroundings should be very much ambitious, and it'll help you to be a better person. Lead the change. I think you all are being aware about this statement. Be the change you want to see. One of my, favorite. This thing should happen this way. You need to be the person who will initiate that. So just lead the change. Just have the power to come up into the market with whatever change you want. That's how Musk started. That's how every entrepreneur started. Ritesh Agarwal, he's a very, at the age of 17, he started OYO. He was very small. He was not even an adult. He was not even eligible for registering a company. But he had this thing in his mind that he wanted to, improve the conditions of hotel industry in our society. And this is how he had this idea. He wanted to bring a change. He executed it well. And today he's the world's youngest billionaire. So it's all about you, your idea, your execution, and your thoughts. Networking. One of the key aspects, it's not just about a person or a networker who needs to network. I think for every single person, and networking is something I personally believe that even a student who is of 9 or 10 years of age, he should start at that age. He should start sitting with people who are talking about possibilities rather than what opportunities are there, who are talking about financial literacy, who are talking about stocks, or who are talking about businesses, who are talking about ideas, who are talking about blunder of possibilities, how things can go ahead. So it's really essential to network with the right people. I have heard recently in an interview, a very famous person has made a quote that instead of going for baby showers, we are at an era that we should go for business showers, whereby all the people like us, they come into a roof and they can just contribute to their resources. They can pool their resources and they can together bring something bigger. And that's an amazing idea. I think we all should work upon it. And whatever age you are in, start networking. Start sitting with people who fit your mindset, or whom you want to be like. So start doing that. What to never do? Never give up. I think if I talk about a baby, before coming to his adult phase, they fall a lot of times. They fall down a lot of times, but they never ever lose hope. Every time they fall, they come back with a bigger hope that yes, I'll be able to work again. That's how a baby, baby grows. If you have ever watched, he's walking and he falls down once, and he again with the same enthusiasm or with a more you know, stronger one. He comes back and then he stands again and then he walks with more excitement. This is how we must learn from it, that they are so small. No one has ever taught them not to give up. But it's a human tendency. We are learning from the very initial phase that we should not give up. But while coming from our, you know, from baby to an adult, we forget this thing. And on every small thing, we just give up. I don't know, why don't we think that every single time we are giving up, we just need to give up one more chance to it. So never ever give up in your life. It's a very bigger factor. Don't forget why you started. When we all start something, we all have some, you know, ambition in our mind. We all have some other thought why we started. It's that is our destination where we want to actually go. So basically that destination, that motivation actually drives you. So you need to be very sure. You need to constantly tell your brain that why have you started, and it will never ever allow you to give up. And third, and the very most important thing, it's that basic thing for which a lot of people don't start their businesses or don't. Even thinking about the fact that for 1/3 of their life, they are doing something which they don't actually want to do. Just because they are afraid of failures. I personally believe that failures, it's something, it's not different from success. It's just a part of success. And I personally feel that if you failed in your initial days, I mean, in your 15s, 17s, 19s or 20s, you're very lucky. Because so never be afraid of your failures. What you do next after your failure is what will define you. Failure happens to everyone. It'll happen to you. It'll happen to me. It'll happen to everyone. So instead of sitting on your hands and thinking, what, you know, how we can do, just find the courage inside of you and say, what wrong I have done there and how can I make it correct? It's really simple and you will be able to refine it more. So just start. Failures will come. Even Musk today, he has faced a lot of failures. Priyanka Chopra, PC, you might have heard her name. Even becoming successful in the Bollywood for so many years. When she tried in Hollywood, when she tried for singing, she failed badly. She never lost her hope. Today, she's not just a Bollywood star, but a Hollywood star as well. And they're not just one example. Mark Zuckerberg. Facebook wasn't the first thing he built. Before Facebook, it was a lot of video games he worked upon, which weren't successful. Harry Potter's author, J.K. Rowling, she wrote a different book. She wrote hundreds of books before the success of Harry Potter. Even if I talk about myself, I failed into two startups before giving this birth to Shunya Pai. So be ready to accept failures and embrace it. Learn from it. Move ahead. Going ahead, when I say learn from it, yes, learn from your failures. If you aren't learning from it, you might have heard about a quote that history repeats itself. Learn from it, otherwise it will repeat, the mistakes will be repeated till the time you are not learning from it. Learn from your surroundings. I think we have a very small life and we can't just experience everything. So it's really, really essential to learn from our surroundings. That's what Jack Ma, Alibaba's you know, founder also says. Every single stuff or consume every learnable stuff that you can. It's really, really essential. And don't just try to take all the experiences yourself. Just learn from your surroundings. People who have committed mistakes or who are successful, just think what was the one thing that made them successful. And just think what was the one thing that that was not right in their, you know, in which led them to the failure. So just learn things around yourself. Learn from you and other people. It's really, that's what I always say. Hamara phone, even that also needs, Android also needs continuous upgradation. Her 20 days baad, your 2 months baad, your phone gives a notification that, hello, I need to be upgraded. I need to be you know, there are some special features. So we are a human. Even we also need upgradation. If we think that with the same 10 years ago person, we'll be able to get into the market, we'll be able to be accepted by everyone, you can't. I'm sorry. It's harder, but you can't be able to make a place for yourself. You need to continuously upgrade yourself. Otherwise, you will be out of the market the way Nokia Ambassador is. So upgrade with new skills, with new ambitions, with new excitement, everything new. Okay, this is something I gave you a brief about your entrepreneurship journey. Now, how you need to, you know, find it or how you need to start it. The very first thing is not everyone is made for every single business. You might have an interest or you might have a particular niche you want to build something into. Find that niche. It might be photography. It might be gaming. It might be tourism. You might have a passion to travel a lot. Just brainstorm something into it. You might like to teach people. That's what Baiju Ravindran liked. And today he built Baiju's, which is the most valued startup of today, having a valuation of $16 billion. It's totally up to you what you have your interest into and how you need to build it. You have a lot of people around you. You can go consult with them. You can refine your idea and you can just work on it. And yeah, you can just build something good out of it. Determine if it needs education. I think basic education, everything needs. Apart from education, here I'm not talking about the degree part. Degree is something which doesn't actually matters in your, you know, in your business or something. Knowledge matters. Focus on the knowledge and not on the degree. You can learn a lot of things. You can, you know, learn from YouTube or Jimmy or something. But, you know, education, if I'll say, it's just a basic one you will require. You just don't need to, you know, take a lot of degrees. Sorry, you don't need to. Plan your business. That's what I said. You have a lot of people around you. You can't consult with. Sit with them. Sit with the like-minded people, as I always say. Just tell your idea to them. And yes, don't make anyone tell you that if you think that your idea is good, have a faith on it. Don't let anyone tell you that you are not good or your idea is not good. Bill Gates showed Microsoft's plan to 1,200 people. 700 people rejected it. 300 people, they said yes. Then out of those 300, there were just 70 people who made him a billionaire today. So make sure that it should be you who should have the maximum faith in your idea and in yourself. So plan your business, consult with people, make a strategy, find your target audience, what target audience you need to work upon. Not everyone is your target audience. Louis Philippe, they don't have their target audience as everyone. Tesla does not have everyone as a target audience, neither the Lamborghini, neither the Mercedes, not even the smaller brands. I take up the smaller brand, Adidas or Reebok. I think Adidas have their particular target audience. Someone might like the sole should be good, the shoes sole should be good. Some audience might have that the fabric should be good, or the shoe should be supportive. So every business knows who is their target audience, and you also need to know it well. Network, as I always say, network with people, network with like-minded people. Give value to your audience. Know what the audience is expecting from you and how you can present it in a manner that provides them maximum value. I think selling is all about providing value to your people. It's nothing more than that. We are consuming things we think is valuable for us. We have let's give it a chance. We have a lot of, we have gone to a mall and we have a lot of appliances in front of us. We have just gone to purchase an induction. Okay, and there are a lot of varieties over it. The sales band will tell you some of the other qualities of each and every appliance. And, you know, while telling it, how the salesperson works, the product, he will tell the maximum features about it or the maximum benefits about it, or the way he'll present it that gives you the maximum value will make you to purchase that product. So it's all about giving value to your people. Might be it's through your selling service or through your content or any other thing or your product, but add value to it. And market. Marketing is really essential, and we are in the era whereby you can't just always put up billboards on roads. So you need to be very conscious about your marketing, which should be properly on the digital platform, because at the moment, I think there is 70% of people who are active on the digital platforms, and you can capture 70% of the market from digital platforms. So be conscious about it. Focus more on digital marketing. Focus more on influential marketing. Find techniques whereby you can generate a maximum audience from the digital platforms. Work upon it. Going ahead with it. You are following all these steps. You are ensuring your checklist to be perfect. But still, a lot of entrepreneurs fail. And you might have a question that why this happens. So it's really simple. 90% of startups, every day, hundreds of startups come into existence. That was the first, food startup, food tech startup. Then you might have heard about Hike. You might have heard about, there are a lot of startups. It's not just one, there are a lot of. So they all fail just because they're not continuously. We are in the era, or we are in the digital era, which needs continuous upgradation, and especially the technical upgradation. So if you're not innovating yourself enough, if you're not continuously upgrading yourself, and you're not adopting to the new market trends, I'm really sorry, you won't be able to survive for long in the market. Just be very sure about what your market is demanding from you, how the market is changing, how the market is evolving. I won't say changing, I would rather say it's evolving. Because we have saw this pandemic made us shift completely from offline to online. We have actually expanded our businesses. Might be there a lot of people who might have their factories or shops or something. Before pandemic, they are just making up the revenues from that offline stream. Today, the pandemic made them to shift onto an online source. So innovate yourself, technically upgrade yourself, adopt new market trends, and I don't think there is any other thing that's required to go on to ahead of your entrepreneurial journey. And here comes the one of the most interesting topics of the 21st, of this session. Actually, a lot of people here are the students, right? And we all are at the phase might of a lot of you might be into a dilemma of where to go and what stream to choose for ourselves, or which niche to go for. So here are a list of some possibilities of the 21st century. You can make your stream into it. You can get into these possibilities, and you can just do miracles. IoT, it is one of the one of the streams whereby you can just research. Research more about it. People who have an interest in the technical fields, just read about it. Try to make, try to design IoT products that will bring, that can provide solutions to people, that can provide beneficial solutions to people. Digital marketing, as I just chance for you to make your career into it, or to make it your niche, just because a lot of businesses, they want to shift onto the digital platforms, and a lot of people don't know how to do it. So you can be that person who will be able to assist businesses or entrepreneurs or SMEs, MSMEs, or even MNCs to shift onto a purely digital economy, purely digital platforms, or purely not just marketing. I talk about everything, even admin, administration, everything should be shifted onto the digital platforms, and thereby you can make your niche into it. Technology, as I already covered that, technology is evolving, and it is a bigger factor for you to make your career into it. There are a lot of things, AI, ML, robotics. You can just research more about it. You can go and subscribe new courses. And you can just continuously upgrade yourself, and you can make your niche into it as well. Nutrition and training. I think this is one of the most essential topics, especially after this pandemic. Already experts, nutritional experts have announced that wellness is a $1 trillion industry. So getting connected with the $1 trillion industry opens your door for the growth. You just need to research more things. At the moment, people are really very conscious about their health. So you can be that person who can, you know, who can help people how to, you know, you can continuously help people to bring how they can bring a nutritional value to themselves. Then come the digitalization factor. Yes, digitalization has already covered. Everything needs to be digitalized in this era, and you can't be very sure about whatever you are doing. It should be purely onto the digital platform, not solely, but at least it should be. You can work offline as well, but it should be online also. Content creation, yes, it is a future business. I think a lot of people, we today are consuming content in a lot of ways. We might spend a time on Facebook or on Instagram or on LinkedIn or on Reddit or on Pinterest or any other platform. So you need to be very cautious about what content you are actually consuming. And content creation is a field. You might have heard about Beer Biceps, Ranveer Labadia, or there's mostly Sane, or a lot of people who are there on Instagram or who are you know, really, really successful. They are just producing content. Sandeep Maheshwari. He is just creating content for people and nothing else. And you know, this is how he's building his personal brand, as well as he's motivating others to do so. Then comes influential marketing, which is somewhere connected to the content creation part. The way you create the content, it makes you, you know, recognized. It makes you a personal brand. And when you become a personal brand, you can actually monetize that. You can go for influential marketing. There are brands or there a huge, you know, scopable niche you want to go. I mean, niche you can go for. Going ahead into the topic comes the leadership part, which is actually very crucial and which is actually very important. When it comes to leadership, I think building something for the people will automatically help you to build for yourself. What does Facebook do? Facebook is not creating any content. We are creating content on Facebook. We are monetizing our content. We are earning out of it. And what is you know, Airbnb doing? We are providing our rentals to Airbnb. We are earning something. And Airbnb is also earning. What happens with Alibaba? Suppliers are posting their products on their site. Alibaba doesn't have their any inventory. Sorry, they don't have their any inventory, or they don't stock anything. What they have is all the suppliers on their boat. The suppliers earn on selling of their product, and Alibaba earns automatically. Uber, they don't even have a single car of them. A lot of people, they have their car on Ubers. They drive, you know, Uber cabs. They learn. The cab drivers earn, and automatically Uber gets profited. So it's all about the leadership. You help others to build, you'll automatically grow. So it's a very crucial part. And when I talk about leadership, leadership is all about man management, managing people in a way that you'll be able to drive solutions for everyone. You'll be able to benefit everyone. So yes, leadership is one of the most crucial decisions, one of the most crucial takes. And yes, Ramayana, the way Hanumanji has played a very strong leadership role in Ramayana itself. If you have any of you, if you have read the entire Ramayana, you might be able to identify it. The way he was always available for suggestions. He always believed into the fact that intelligent one is always small. You are intelligent, you like to remain bored. Having a sense of gratitude or always bowing down is one major thing that will help you to grow. Always having a down-to-earth, attitude will always help you to grow more and more in your life. Attitude of gratitude is really, really essential. I think it should be an important part of everyone's life. Being thankful for everything you get in your life, from the moment you wake up in your day and the moment you sleep, you should be thankful for every small thing. The people you are surrounded with, the people who care for you, especially your family, being grateful for you are alive today, being grateful for that you are having a good home to live, being grateful for that you are even alive is one of the best things you can do to stay positive. Give credit to others for achievements, being always, helping others, giving them credits for the achievements is one of the traits Hanumanji has depicted in Ramayana itself. Always respecting others, not just your seniors, but even your juniors or the people of the same age. Everyone needs respect, and I think respect or dignity is one of the very crucial things everyone needs. So if you want respect, you should learn others to, you should learn to give respect to others. And this is how the things work. It's purely a give and take thing. You give respect to people, you get respect. So be very crucial about it. Never fear and stay positive always. Yes, at the moment we are into the stage, we don't fear from anything, but we fear from failures. So don't actually fear from failures in everything. It's just a part of your life. Learn from it, move ahead, and just grow ahead in your life. Don't be still anywhere that you're into a problem and you are still. It won't help you out. You are still into the same thing. So continuously try to get out of it and, accept your failures and learn from it and stay positive always. And always have a faith in the process, in the Supreme God, because it's my personal experience that, if God has put you into a situation, He might have also find a way for you to get out of it. He's taking your test just because He knows that you have the power to win it. So always have a faith in the process. It's the same leadership examples from Mahabharata as well. If you have a chance to read it, just read. If you get a good mentor, it's worthful than an entire army. A good mentor always drives you towards, better things, towards success, towards good thoughts, everything. So make sure that the person you are consulting or the person you are taking the mentorship from, he must be what you want to be in the next few years of yours. So if you want to be something, just make sure that the person you are taking the mentorship from, he should be at that stage. Neglect no one. Accept everyone. Take everyone, have an open openness every single time. You're always open to everyone. You are neglecting no one. People love this thing. And I think this is something which is one of the very crucial aspects of leadership. And this is one of the crucial things one learns from Mahabharata. Leadership, as I always said, it's not about the power. It's all about helping others to build something for themselves. It's all about empowering others. I heard a lot of times there's a very, very slight difference between what a boss does and what a leader does. Boss is pretending to give orders to people. He's taking the full use of his power. When it comes to a leader or a leadership, it's all about being with them, supporting your team, and empowering them to be good, better, and best. Strategy. I think a leader is one person who knows how to strategize things and how to use that strategy at the right time with the right tool. So it's really, really essential to have a good leadership, and it's really, really essential to be very sure about yourself when you come into the leadership part. So with this was all about the entrepreneurship journey, what you need to be very careful about, what you need to learn, how you need to upgrade yourself, what attitude you should have, where you can go into, what niche or what, aspects or what streams you can make your business or your niche into. So it was a completely a package of all the things you require in your entrepreneurship journey. As I always say, that fortune favors the bold, or victory belongs to the brave. So in order to be at that success stage, or to be at that victory, it's really essential you to accept all the challenges or the failures which is coming into your stream. So be acceptable to it to reach at, you know, that stage, that success stage. So with this, thank you everyone, and have an amazing day. Thank you so much.